Yung si Robles po, tumawag sa inyo?
No.
Wala po si Robles sa meeting niyo doon sa taas? Sa Shangri-La? Sa
wala po. Wala po.
Wala po. Okay. Tapos na tumuli na po kayo na. Tapos ano, ano, wala na po kayo sasabihin doon sa inyong salaysay, sa inyong kinukwento sa amin ngayon?
Opo, natapos na po yun. Sandali-sandali lang yun eh. But okay. The following day, I know that I informed the media about this.
How you informed the media?
Opo, 27. Alam na ng buong media yan.
Na nag-offer.
Yung the way it was told to me by Sombero, ang media na nag-conclude na sinusuwalan ako.
Pero at that time, may tumatakas na po, no?
Nung pa pong 24 yung raid eh, 25, 26, may tumatakas na.
Nakatakas, in fact, about 57?
Hindi lamang po. Ang tingin ko dun eh, mga 800 ang nakatakas eh.
800 ang nakatakas?
Punong-puno yung mga coffee shops, yung mga McDonald's, yung mga hotel. Sa Clark Development, punong-puno ng mga Chinese.
So nag-hotel sila?
Yung po ang report na dumating sa akin. Para lang makali sila dun sa Fontana.
They were very uncomfortable. Ang suggestion nyo, ganun ba? Masyadong nahihirapan, dalawa lang ang palingkuran. So lumabas sila at nagpunta sila sa mga hotel.
Hindi lamang po yun. Yung talagang in the first place, talagang hindi na napigilan. Yung unang hours ng raid, marami na nakatakas.
Nakapunta na sa China?
Yun ang sinasabi sa akin na nanggaling yun, especially yung mga employees sa Fort Ilocanja.
Bago ako kumunta na, nagtatry na si Secretary, si Commissioner Morant. Kayong in charge dyan, hindi ba?
Yes, sir. But yes, Your Honor. But there was a yung aming fugitive search unit who was leading the yung FSU namin was leading the operation. I was not there, sir, sa Fontana. They were there, but yun nga po, ang information was...
Pag pumasok ko ang isang Chinese, nire-record niya yan, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor. Dumadaan po sa ating counters.
At pag nagtrabaho yan, tine-check nyo kung nagtatrabaho yan dun sa hotel o doon sa Fontana? Yung anong pasok nila? Tourists o laborers?
Ito pong karamihan ng pumasok ata sa Fontana ay mga tourist po.
Tourists?
Marami yung tourist visa na nahuli doon, which is a violation of the conditions of their stay.
And they're from, I know that. So they're from mainland China?
Most of them, Your Honor, yes, sir.
And where could they be other than other than the others, other than mainland China? Taiwan?
Some from, I think, Hong Kong, sir, and
Hong Kong. Macau. Yes. And that is acceptable because lumalabas na nagigaming dyan, ibang hindi lang Mandarin, Cantonese, Macau, Hakka, yung mga Chinese.
Yes, Your Honor, because we learned na yung involved in online gaming, yung kanilang clientele is nasa labas naman.
How long have you been in your position?
I assume only last July 1st.
Last July?
16. Yes, sir.
And during the briefing, the passover of your position by your predecessor, sino ang predecessor niyo?
Commissioner Heron, Your Honor.
Wala siyang sinabi na ito, mga Chinese ito pumapasok para mag-gaming?
Wala naman,
online Your Honor. Gaming. Wala?
Wala po.
Wala ka suspicion, ang dami-daming Chinese nagpupunta doon.
Meron po akong naririnig but hindi ko ma-validate.
Meron kayong intelligence fund?
We have, Your Honor.
Hindi niyo sinay-check yan sa dami niya mga yan.
It is being
wala used... nagpupunta sa inyo sa Clark para makita naglalaro yan mga yan na doon sa Fontana.
Actually, Your Honor, it's being used by the intelligence division. Not only for the online gaming, may nahuli nga po kaming 144 on August of this year also.
Malaki yung sinasabi na ko, ano, 800 ang nakatakas. Do you confirm that?
I think, Your Honor, what the Secretary of Justice means is during the conduct of operation, may shifting mo kasi sila. Baka ho yung next shift hindi pa nakarating, hindi ho nasama yon. All those that were arrested were those in place on site.
Okay, I'll get back to you later. Mr. Yes, Argusino. Being a very good intelligence officer, I'm trying to probe you on your credibility. You know that 1,300 plus another 2,000, that's 3,300. And we just sit around in our offices, hunky-dory. These people are coming to our office, to our country, not paying taxes, taking the jobs that belong to Filipinos, and you'd never made a raid?
Kaya nga po sila na-raid, and before that, mayroon na rin pa kami mga nahuli na 144 po doon sin sa Clark.
And who conducted the raid? Who initiated the raid?
Yung unang operation po, yung...
No, I'm talking about the first 1,300.
Yung 1,300 po, this was a DOJ-directed operation po.
DOJ, it did not come from you. It came directly from the Secretary of Justice because how did you initiate that raid, Mr. Secretary?
Mr. Chairman, we are in receipt of an anonymous letter sometime in September reporting to us the various illegals in the Fontana Leisure Park. On the basis of that, I decided that to issue a department order and inviting the two commissioners, General Morente, to plan about 3 days before the raid. And that's how it started. That was around November 21, and we raided it in November 24.
Based on that information, you directed Commissioner Morente na mag-conduct ng raid?
That's right, Mr. Chairman.
And immediately thereafter, your intelligence officer here says he got information that there are two na nag-aareglo.
Well, information...
Were you aware of that?
Information kept coming by way of text that some people are making or arranging...
Overtures to fix it.
As a matter of fact, some are already escaping. And yung 800 people that escaped is only my calculation because before the raid started, we were expecting from 3,000 to 4,000 people to be... detained or caught by this raid.
Now, would you say that when you took over, yung Fontana matagal na nag-ooperate yan, di ba?
Yes,
Would it be fair to say that they've been bringing these Chinese over right under our noses and nothing was happening?
I think so, yes, Your Honor.
And you did say that it has been going on for the last 10 years.
Yeah, most probably, Your Honor, although...
And there were operations in Lawak, there were operations in Clark,
but as late,
and I'm shocked they even used Subic as a, they were getting employees from Subic allegedly.
Yes, Honor, as a matter of fact, when I helped Secretary Tugadi as Vice President for the Legal Affairs of Clark Development, Fontana is there operating, and
no raid was conducted by immigration at that time.
Because they thought that even the Clark Development thought that they are doing that legally because they are duly authorized by CESA or the First Cagayan.
By CESA?
Through First Cagayan.
But CESA is only good for up to its territorial jurisdiction, is it not?
That's correct. That's why...
You cannot extend the jurisdiction because it's conferred by law.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman.
And you cannot put... online gaming in another territory. Is that correct?
It should be the case, Mr. Chairman.
And therefore, Commissioner of Immigration of the last 10 years and even beyond, perhaps, should have conducted raids on these people.
That's right, Mr. Chairman. That's why, from the statement of General Sombero, he told me that matagal na niyang walang nag-aalaga kay Jack Lam.
That is why I'm trying to lay the premises, and I apologize to my colleagues because gusto natin makita muna yung boom picture. Now, having said that, natataka lang ako, kung si General Kalima, kinausap ka at sinasabi mo, again, either you're too dense or you're just trying to hide your guilt, Mr. Argusino, kinakausap ka, may pinapahiwatig sa iyo, natutulungan ka niya. Correct? That's what you said. Matutulungan kita. Meron akong tape. Matutulungan kita.
Yun po yung sinabi niya sa akin.
Okay. Oh, anong sabi mo? Anong sagot mo doon, Mr. Kalima?
Your Honor, this was already part yung meron tayong tinatawag na tradecraft sa intelligence po, Your Honor. I was trying to get information from them. And ang nakita ko na pamaraan ng kung paano kumakuha ng information sa kanila is to get into the comfort zone. Kaya nga ganun po ang lapit
ko sa kanila. But it can be said, General Kalima, that you know that they got 50 million, and then pumapasok ka ngayon at sasabihin mo, tutulungan kita, na pumaparte ka. Can it be said?